Hey everybody, this is Michael yet again, and welcome back to my channel. Well guys, doing another movie review, or giving you my thoughts on this movie. And as you know guys, the film is The Raid Redemption. And I don't think I've heard one bad word about this film since I actually saw a couple of reviews on it. As a matter of fact, what I've read and what I've seen, people tend to love this movie. The Raid Redemption. I actually got this at Best Buy for only $4.99. And there's the front once again up close, guys. This is the unrated version of the film, and I wouldn't even begin to know what the rated version of the film looked like, but I'll show you the inside of it right quick. And once again, guys, there's an ultraviolet download of this film. Get your pencils ready, get your mouses ready to freeze frame this, because I'm going to show it to you. Whoever gets it first, claims it first, gets to watch the movie if you want it in your collection. But here you go, digital download for The Raid Redemption. Okay, you'll have to hold it up. There's the movie itself there, guys. And it has a poster behind the disc and all, and I'll show it to you. In the Blu-ray. There we go. Pretty kick-ass if you ask me. Okay guys, let's put this back in here. Here's the inside of this. More advertisements. Let's put this back. I did watch this last night, guys. And right off the bat, guys, I gotta tell you that I enjoyed it. I actually had a good time with this film, The Raid Redemption. Isn't this South Korean or Indonesian? Indonesian. And it was dubbed in English. Sometimes the dubbing wasn't quite so good. But, you know, this is a movie that, you know, the dubbing really doesn't have to be too good, because what I got out of it was the great stunt work, which, you know, this film features some really, really great stunt work. I mean, I gotta tell you guys, I was just, you know, enthralled in watching all the great way the fights were choreographed and all that. I mean, they did a really great job on that, guys, I gotta tell you. One of the best choreographed films that I've seen. Now, granted, I haven't seen a whole lot of them. I used to watch quite a few kung fu movies, and they had some excellent choreographed too, but this one had some really good choreographed. And basically, the plot is as simplistic as they come. A group of 20 elite police officers are going into this building to arrest this drug peon, this crime lord, this crime boss, who has taken shelter in this building, and he's pretty much got every apartment in the building tied to him, and they'll protect his ass, and they're going against the cops, and that's it. That's what you have in this film, guys. It reminds me a lot of the plot of Dread, but this film is definitely rated R, guys. I got to tell you, I was really kind of shocked by the violence in it. Not so much that you think I'm thinking, oh wow, I can't believe they did that. Not that kind of shocked. Shocked in that in today's world, they actually still make movies like this. You know, I mean, it's as violent as they come. I mean, people getting their body parts cut off, gunshots to the eyes. Stab wounds to the face. I mean, this film pretty much has it all. It's almost shocking. And alone, guys, I gotta tell you what I enjoyed about this film. I enjoyed the intense action. I enjoyed watching the choreographed fight scenes. I enjoyed the action. You know, sometimes it's nice to just sit back and watch a movie, and you don't have to think about, oh, how do you do that? What's the story behind this? Oh, we got to figure this out. Let's type in Google and try to figure out how this happened. Why was this happening? I got to tell you guys, this was a really enjoyable film. It says on the front, the best action film in decades, and I would definitely got to agree that it's probably in my top five best action films over the last 3 or 4 years. It's definitely a good film. One ruthless crime lord, 20 elite cops, 30 floors of hell. I love that tagline. But yeah, guys, I can't say any more about this. I can't make this review any longer than what it is to say that, you know, how cool can I say this movie is? It's a really cool, intense action film, great martial arts stunts, great fight scenes, and enjoyed it immensely. Now, what I am kind of disappointed about, after, you know, looking online and reading up on the movie a little bit, what really disappoints me is that America is making a remake of this movie for American audiences. And it's like, why? Why in the hell are they remaking this? I mean, it's like fucking shit. Why don't they just put money into the sequel of this film and do it that way? Why do we need an American PG-13 rated version of this? I don't get it, guys. I just don't. But anyway, this film cost an amazingly $1.8 million. Maybe $1.1 million, but can you believe that? With all the stunt work in this, all the effects work, the practical effects, the fight scenes, it's just amazing to me that this was made on that budget, especially with all the people involved in this. But, yeah, I am disappointed that they are making a remake of this already in the States here, guys. I mean, yeah, that's something. You know, on this budget, guys, you would think the producers and the director behind this film would have to be able to teach American filmmakers something, especially like how to manage their freaking money and how to make a film that, you know, miles ahead in terms of action scenes and just a visual take of the entire film. Just fast-paced, great editing, not any shaky cam all over the place. I mean, you know, these filmmakers could really teach Hollywood a lesson, and hopefully they're listening. But apparently they're not listening too hard because they're making a remake of this movie. A remake? What is this? But anyway, guys, something I wanted to say, and one thing about the remake is they're getting all the stunt coordinators and choreographers that did this film for the American version of the movie. Be interesting to see, but you know, as I'm watching this and thinking about the American version, you already know that this damn film isn't going to be touched as far as quality and which one's better and all that. The Raid Redemption, probably one of the best action films I've seen in a long time, guys. And you know, after watching a film of this intensity, it really would be nice to see an American film this intense, but we know that's not going to happen. But anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and I will see you at the next movie review. Enjoyed it.